He absolutely will not compromise. He'll do anything to save a whale. The film is about many things. It's about the life of Captain Paul Watson, an eco-activist who's been out on the high seas fighting illegal poaching and fishing and whaling for many years. But at the same time, it's about whales.
Property in our societies has more value than life. Property is sacred, life is expendable.
I've been sort of an environmentalist for a long time, but I didn't think about the oceans as much as I thought about other things. And now that's flipped. I think about the oceans more than other things. So I think that that's something that is a change I'll have for the rest of my life. Since Paul Watson, at the time that I started my project, had two international red notices, which are international arrest warrants, for the first time at 68, he could not go out on the ocean. He got special permission to enter the US and he can't cross a border or he might be arrested and extradited to Japan. So I wanted to see how he would handle being on land, you know, for the first time and being sort of trapped in that way. And would he excel or would he go crazy or what would he do? And he ended up getting a lot more captains and a lot more boats, and Sea Shepherd ended up growing. But I was catching him at a time where he wasn't able to do the thing he loved. And that's why I wanted to make the film.
But really, the property is already owned. The bears own the forests. The whales own the ocean. We're taking that away from them.
So the message is to think about the oceans first and foremost. But the second message is, you know, the film is a portrait of what it takes to be a lifelong ocean activist and the sacrifices that you have to make. And I hope people look at Captain Paul Watson and they see those sacrifices. So I hope they take that away too.